Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 15.0.1. This is available to the public everywhere around the world at the exact same time and is available now on all supported devices. So if you have an iPhone 6S, 6S Plus, iPhone 7, all the way up to the latest iPhone 13 and 13 Pro, you'll have a supported device and you can install it now. Also, iPadOS 15.0.1 is out as well and supports iPad Air 2 and newer. So if you have an iPad Air 2 like this one, all the way up to the latest iPads Pro, you'll have a supported device. Now, this particular update, if you're not seeing it, you can find it by going to Settings, going to General, and then Software Update. If you're not seeing it still, turn off automatic updates, go back, and then check for an update again, and you should see the update. The only time you would not see the update is if you're a developer or beta tester that's on iOS 15.1 beta 2 or the betas. Otherwise, you'll see this update if you're still on iOS 14 or just iOS 15. You'll be able to see it. Now, you may have already seen that this update came in at 554 megabytes. That's on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, and it was just a little bit bigger on the iPhone 13 Pro at 608.9 megabytes. So it's going to vary from device to device, but it will vary depending on which device you're on. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then General, then About. Now, you can see the build number is 19A348, and this particular build brings some bug fixes to our device. So those of you running iOS 15, there's been some bugs in it and they've resolved them, more so on the iPhone 13 models. Now, the first thing is there's no new modem update, at least on the iPhone 13 Pro when I checked it. So there's no modem update on it. And so you won't see anything there. But if you have a different device, it's possible you do have a modem update, but I was not able to find any there. Like I said, this is mostly a bug fix. So as far as the first new feature or bug fix that they've updated, it has to do with the Apple Watch. There was an issue where you'd try to unlock your phone using an Apple Watch if you had a face mask on or your face was covered and it wouldn't work. This has been resolved. So if you're not familiar with that, I have it on my other iPhone here. And if I lock, you'll see it says unlocking with iPhone. So now it unlocked my Apple Watch. But if I have my face obscured, maybe I have a mask on, and let me show you that. Now you can see on my Apple Watch that it says unlocked by this watch. My iPhone 13 Pro Max was unlocked. That previously was having connectivity issues where it just said it couldn't have a connection to the Apple Watch on your device. So now they've fixed that connection issue. You've got a secure connection and you can unlock properly. It seemed to only affect the iPhone 13 models though. So that has been resolved. Now, the next thing is a lot of people were having an odd storage bug. So a message that your storage was full. So again, under Settings, if you go to General and then iPhone Storage, a lot of people were having a storage bug or having a message that would say your storage is full, even though you had plenty of storage. So you can see here, it says I'm using 53.9 gigabytes of 256 gigabytes. And if I go to About, you can see the actual storage numbers at the bottom with the capacity are correct now. Prior to this, it could say you had more available than your actual capacity. So this seems to be resolved. Now, the third thing Apple fixed has to do with Apple Watch. Now, Apple did not release a separate watchOS update, but rather fixed it through the communication issue you were having with maybe the unlock iPhone issue. So if you go into your watch, maybe you go under mindfulness, and you can do this on the iPhone as well if you use Fitness Plus, and you go into Fitness Plus audio meditations and start an audio meditation. If you start this, sometimes it could trigger a workout even though you weren't working out. So they've resolved that. And again, you can find that on your iPhone here. If you go under the Fitness Plus app, under meditation, you have audio meditations. So it's the same sort of thing, but it was triggering workouts on your watch, and that has been resolved for Fitness Plus subscribers. Now, as far as the touch bug that's there on the iPhone 13 devices, they have not mentioned at all that they've resolved this. Now, since installing the update, the touch bug does not seem to be there. However, it doesn't mean they've resolved it, as they've already acknowledged it, or a lot of people have been experiencing it, and it seems to be fixed in iOS 15.1 beta 2. So if you go in and maybe touch on an icon here or just open an app, sometimes it just doesn't do anything. You have to touch multiple times and it doesn't understand it. Once you go into the apps now, it seems to work as you would expect, and seems to be quite fast, but they did not mention anything to do with that, even though it seems to be resolved. Now, the only other thing they mentioned as far as this update has to do with security updates. Now, there could be some security updates they didn't publish, but if you go to Apple's security website, you can see here where it says iOS 15.0.1 and iPadOS 15.0.1, this update has no published CVE entries. And so it talks about what it is, when they've published it, but they haven't given any public entries. So there's a possibility that they did resolve some things in the background, but at this point they have not published those, so we don't know exactly what they are. Now, when it comes to iPadOS 15.0.1, the only fixes mentioned here have to do with the settings app incorrectly displaying that a storage issue, and also the audio meditations with Fitness Plus. No other things have been fixed or resolved, at least that they've let us know about. So that doesn't mean they've fixed all bugs with iOS 15, and there's still issues that could remain. But at this point, at least they've fixed a few different things and probably patched some security holes as well. Now, as far as overall battery life, it does take a few days to measure. Since everything just installed, it will take a few days to measure since it's updating things in the background and sort of processing and indexing. And once that's complete, I would expect battery life to improve if it hasn't already. I can show you my battery life on my 13 Pro Max that I've used for a week, but it won't give you a real life idea of what 15.0.1 is. But so far, battery life has been phenomenal. And I showed that in my review of iPhone 13 Pro Max. So if we look at the last 9 days, we'll go 2 days ago, I had 4 hours and 14 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 54 minutes of screen off time. If we go the day before, I used FaceTime a lot and had almost 5 hours of screen on time and only used about 50% of my battery life. So far, iOS 15, at least on the 13 Pro Max, has been great. Hopefully those bugs resolve some issues with connectivity to the Apple Watch and save us some additional battery life as well. Now, performance overall seems to be okay, not just on newer devices where you have the fastest processors, but also on the older device I have here, the iPhone 7. So scrolling seems to be smooth still. It is loading some data in the background, and I can tell that because the device is quite warm. So the iPhone 7 seems to be fairly warm. It is the slowest processor of the bunch and did take the longest to update, so it is processing in the background. But you can see it's still fully usable, but it is a little bit warm. If we go into the App Store, you'll see that it's working just fine. So apps are loading as expected. And of course, if you give it a few hours when everything completes, it should be just fine. Now, as far as if you should update to iOS 15.0.1, well, I definitely would update if you're on an iPhone 13 device or already on iOS 15. This will fix that issue with your Apple Watch, as well as have additional bug fixes and maybe some they haven't told us about as well. So I would highly recommend updating. Now, as far as iOS 15.1 and when to expect that, I think that will be within a few weeks. Based off of what Apple did last year, it took about a month from the release of iOS 14 to give us iOS 14.1, and we had something in the middle. So maybe we'll have from the 20th, maybe we'll have something on the 11th, or they could really fix a lot of issues with iOS 15.1, add additional features, and give it a few more betas, making it available in late October or early November. We don't really know yet, but I would expect a beta this coming week since it seems like we're on a weekly cycle. So I would expect iOS 15.1 around then, with maybe an Apple event in October showing off the M1X MacBook Pros. So look for all of those. And of course, I'll keep you updated as soon as I know as well. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description below. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.